All right, Matt, our third fight, UFC 246 on the prelims. This is a banger at 125 pounds. This is one of the fights that I'm most excited about tonight. You have Tim Elliott, who has, listen, he's challenged for a title in the past.
He's a fun guy to watch.
Taking on the Russian bullet, Askar Askarov. And listen, if you saw Askar Askarov's debut, it was against Brandon Moreno.
Such a good fight.
I predicted it, and I believe it. I think Brandon Moreno is going to be a champ by the end of 2020 at flyweight. So I'm thinking pretty highly of him, but at the same time, I've been pumping the tires of Askar Askarov since he was with ACB and then ACA. This guy is 10-0 with the one draw against Moreno in his UFC debut.
He got lucky with that draw, for being honest.
All 10 of those wins are by finish, 7 of them by submission. He also has a twister submission on his record against Anthony Leone. A lot of people might recognize that name. But he's taken on Tim Elliott. Like I said, he's challenged for a title in the past, won the season of The Ultimate Fighter, challenged Demetrius Johnson. It was a loss. It was a loss by decision. He had
did pretty well.
He had some moments in that fight. But since then, he just hasn't really been able to right the ship. He had a really long layoff, about 2 years. And his only two wins, one over Luis Smolka and another one over Mark De La Rosa. The losses to some of the better ones in the game. His last one to UCA Formiga got finished in the first round. Devison Figueiredo, rather. And he also got finished by Ben Wynn. Where's Ben Wynn been? But in this fight, you have to consider the fact that Tim Elliott is going to have the advantage on the feet. Askarov's going to have the advantage in grappling, especially when it gets to the ground.
This is my problem with this fight. I think this could be another fight of the night type contender, just due to the fact that both guys are very scramble-based. If we watched the Askar Askarov fight when he fought Brandon Moreno, he did have a tough time with Moreno when Moreno kind of went weird on him grappling-wise. When he didn't just do, okay, I'm going to go half guard to full guard, Brandon Moreno was like doing somersaults and stuff, trying to get in better positions, and Askar Askarov can't get people off his back. And maybe that was just Brandon Moreno, who is a really good grappler. Like, I'm not giving him credit for that, but Moreno had his back for about 4.5 minutes in that fight, and if Tim Elliott can somehow find a way to tire Askar Askarov out and then start to work his grappling on him, it should be a great fight. But I do think a lot of this is going to be Askarov trying to get Elliott down by the cage, Elliott trying to scramble out of it, and it should make for a really entertaining fight. Like, I'm really looking forward to this one. With all that being said, I just feel like Askarov has a little bit more power on the feet, but Tim Elliott's definitely going to be the busier striker.
Yeah.
And if Tim Elliott can start putting together combinations, being elusive like he can be when he's at his very best, he might be able to squeak out a decision win. But I just feel like Askar Askarov, the more likely the situations is, he's going to go for a takedown. Tim Elliott's going to make a bad scramble, and Askar's just going to be able to find his back or whatnot and finish him with a submission.
Matt telling me I'm completely wrong, not giving me time to elude. That was exactly what I was going to say. Tim Elliott's going to have the speed. He's going to be able to put together the combos, and if he can move in and out of range, he could have an advantage there. That's where I was going with it. Thank you for that, Matt. As far as the odds are concerned, -125 favorite is Askar Askarov, +110 for Tim Elliott. Again, Askarov only his second fight in the UFC, and like we said, Elliott has already challenged for a title. And in terms of the Tapology picks, because they're important, 942 votes here, 76% picking Askar Askarov. Matt, I'm going to agree. I think Askarov's ceiling is very high. I think it's higher than Elliott's at this point. I think he's a top five contender, one of those guys that's going to stick around up at the top. I really think highly of Askar Askarov. Just like I do with Brandon Moreno. I know fellow Loudmouth MMA Podcast Network friend Marcel Dorf is very high on Askar Askarov, so we'll throw that out there.
He's definitely winning this fight, though.
But yeah, we're both going to go with Askar Askarov, but really looking forward to UFC 246. Oh, yeah. You're not going to want to miss our 2-minute predictions here on YouTube with Fight Night Picks, Matt.